They are going to take you through the production of insecticide, air pressure, and Dettol.
Measuring cups.
And we have the measuring spoons. This is called tablespoon. Why this one is called teaspoon? So we have other things like the drum or keg. These are the kegs. For it to be seen. So we have other things like the funnels. These are the funnels. Because I said materials and equipment. Funnels, we have hand gloves, we have nose cover, we have eye goggles. You need your eye goggles in order to protect your eyes. We have our sieve. Sieve. Your sieve could either be material or the other type of seed in form of clay. So with this, I believe you will be able to produce whatever you want to produce. And based on the materials or the chemicals that you need to use for this production, one, you can see here we have what we call BB force. But if you are able to get BB force, we have another one. Sniper. This is the same BD force in the small quantity. This is 100 ml of our BD force. We have resin. This is our resin. It's called linear measurement. So we have Elcator. This is our Elcator and this is the color of it. Can you see? This is the quantity measurement we are doing. Quarter liter. We have formalin. This is our formalin. And this is the quantity measurement for the formalin, quarter liter as well. You can either put quantity measurement. You can either use. Perfume chemicals, they are optional to insecticide. We have the perfume. We have perfume. This is perfume. colored. So you can leave your production the way it is. But if you feel that you don't like this color, you can add any color of your choice in order to give you whatever attractive look you wish to have. So this is the production itself. With this production,
function of mento.
Mento is used for strong cold. It is also used to diffuse the air or the scent on the air. We use mento for killing of insects and other microscopic organisms. So, we have other chemicals. We have perfume. The perfume is for scent, to give you pleasant smell. We have our color. Our color is just to have an attractive look. And we have methanol. This methanol, it is used in the production of air freshener to nullify or to neutralize the work of tetanol and other chemicals that are being used in the production. So we have the use of what? Camphor. This is camphor. We call it added to our production. Camphor is used to repel insects or for killing of insects. So these are the products or materials that we use for the production. These are the chemicals we use for the production, rather. So, what are the production steps? Sorry, this is our tetanol. Tetanol, can you see? This is tetanol. Tetanol helps to activate the work of the perfume. It helps other chemicals in use to. It helps to nullify the use of all the chemicals that we have used in these productions. So, and it is a foaming agent. So, let's produce. The first thing you need to do when producing air freshener, after you've measured out your production, after you have measured out your chemicals, you need to mix what we call tetapon. Measure your quantity of tetapon. The quantity of tetapon we are required to produce this 5-10 liter production or air freshener is 1/2 teaspoon. You measure it, this is your teaspoon, remember? You measure your 1/2 teaspoon, you need to dissolve it.
Dissolve it first.
With methanol. There are three sub-ways to produce this air freshener. It's either you use methanol and tetapon. You dissolve the both together, or you use the step whereby you mix tetapon and perfume. You dissolve it together in a separate bowl, and in methanol and menthol, you equally dissolve it in another separate bowl. But the step we are going to use here is the step where we mix our tetapon and methanol together. You dissolve it. That is, you stir and allow it to dissolve.
Egbe soke, bring it up.
So after you've done that, you allow it for some minutes. Then you pour your water. Make sure that whatever you use for this production is well mixed, because if there is any chemical, it can affect the work of your work. The mixture of that tetapon and methanol, you need to take it, pour it into your mixing or your production bowl. Pour it inside your production bowl. You still have to stir. You stir. After that, you take your menthol. Our menthol. Remember, our menthol, the quantity is what? 1/2 teaspoon. You pour it. You stir. To add your water, the first 5 liters that you have measured out. Add it to your solution. And you stir. We enable whatever incense that is found within the home, or inside the home rather, where this air freshener is being made use of. It will repel such incense away from the home. Those are the ways on how to make our air freshener. With this, we are through with the production of air freshener. Now, like I said, the first thing you need to do when producing air freshener, you mix your tetherpole and methyl, just the way we have done. You mix tetherpole and methanol together. Mix your tetherpole and methanol together. Allow it to stay for 3 minutes while you are still arranging other things. So after that, you keep your production bowl, place your production bowl. The content, the solution you've mixed together after 3 minutes, you pour it into the production bowl. After you pour it, you add the quantity of your methyl. The quantity of methyl we use is 1/2 teaspoon. You add it to the solution, you stir it. After you've done that, you add the quantity of your perfume, measure that. We said we use 118. That 118 is 125 ml. If your cup measurement is marked with ml, like this one, we have ml. So, you measure your perfume, you add to it, you stir. You stir. After stirring, you pour the first quantity of your water. Measure that 5 liter water, you pour it to your solution, you stir it. You will see that the color has changed. It will look milky color. The color will look industrial camphor. You equally stir. Immediately you've done that, add 2 liters of your water to it. Again, you stir. Then after that, you add your color, which is the last one of last chemical that we use. So in case your color is in powder form, you dissolve it first before adding to the induction. So those are the ways to produce both air freshener and the insecticides. And if you are to produce more larger quantity, you follow the sample measurement to arrive at whichever production or whichever quantity you want to produce. So I would like to say thank you and welcome once again. Good day.
Can I? Please, what is the active agent or chemical in insecticide?
It is called DDFOS. If you make the DDFOS.
What is the function of formalin in the production of insecticide?
Formalin is a preservative agent. It is a preservative agent and at the same time it kills insects.
What is the disadvantage of insecticide chemical?
The disadvantage is that if it happens to spill on your body, it can cause some peel. As in, it is very corrosive.
What is the alternative chemical used in place of DDFOS?
We call it Sniper.
Sniper.
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is the most effective base for the production of insecticide?
We used 4 liters chlorazine and all round total we have 5.
Thank you. Now listen to the questions for questions I want to ask for air freshener. What is the tell us a good example of perfume that you can use for air freshener?
One of them is called vanilla. We have the one called vanilla. We have the one called strawberry. We have blue water and so on.
Okay, thank you. What is the function of Texapon in the production of air freshener?
Yes, the Texapon helps to emulsify all the chemicals that we use in the production. It also is also a foaming agent. It is a foaming agent.
Okay, in the production of air freshener, what is the work of camphor?
The camphor is a killing agent. It kills insects and at the same time it kills it.
Okay, thank you.
Good afternoon, students. My name is Mrs. Omisha Akindupe Dupe A. I want to take you how to produce the crop. First of all, the chemical we need Texapon, which is 1/4 kg. We need palm oil, which is...
Mommy, we need palm oil. You will tell him.
The chemical we need in the production of the top, we need Texapon, which is 1/4 kg. And this Texapon is a little foamy in the production of Dettol. We need palm oil. That one is 1/2 liter. We need 1/2 liter. And the function of that palm oil is to kill the germs, followed by chlorosanone. This chlorosanone we need 1/4 liter. This one also is germ killer. Followed by phenol. This phenol will need 1/8 liter. It also kills germs. Then we need water. This is our water, which is 2 liter. Followed by IPA. That IPA also is germ killer and it's used to prevent our body. So followed by the last one, which is color. This color is water soluble and it's brown in color. Now we have equipment and tools. We need measuring cup. This is 1 liter measuring cup. This is 1/4 liter measuring cup. This is 1/2 liter measuring cup. We have a measuring spoon. This is teaspoon. This is a teaspoon. Then we need, this is tablespoon. We are using it in our production. This is nose ring cover. This is safety goggle. And this is hand glove. So we have funnel. It's very important in the production. We have big funnel stick in case we want to do more than what we want to produce now. And also we have mixing bucket. This one is very big bowl. When we want to produce more than 10 liters, more than 5 liters, more than 20 liters of water. Now we want to go through our production now. So the first thing we need is persapon, which is 1/4 liter. This one is 1/4 kg, This one is 1/4 kg. So followed by palm oil. This one will be 1/2 liter. I want to measure 1/2 liter out of this keg. This is 1/2 liter. And this pump also is 1/2 liter. We will stir it till when that pressure point is dissolved. Very well till that pressure point is totally dissolved. Now I want to measure chlorosanol. Chlorosanol, that one will be 1/4 liter. This is chlorosanol. I want to measure 1/4 liter out of this cake. This is 1/4 liter. I want to pour it inside the production. We have to stir it the chemical mix together. liter of water inside our production. This is 1 liter cup. We have to stir it very well so that the chemical and the water will all mix together. We want to use IPA now, and the IPA also is 2 liters. So I will measure 2 liters of IPA now. After that, we have to stir it together. So, hello students, once again I want you to observe something. When we are mixing the chemical together, it comes in whitish color. But now when I add IPA into our production, it comes in brownish color. You see the reaction of IPA in our production. So, the next step, which is the last step for the production of Dettol, is Dettol color. I told you earlier before we start our production that Dettol color come out in brown color and it is water soluble. So in order to add our color, we don't have any measurements and or any quantity. The color is optional. In every production is optional. So now I want to use teaspoon to measure our color. So the teaspoon will be for my own production that I produce now. I want to use 1 teaspoon as my own color measurement. You should look at it very well. This is 1 teaspoon. I pour it inside my production. You can see now when I put color inside my product, now you can see the color comes out in brown color and it is very, very fine in neat. You can see it. This is our Dettol. So, thank you. top production is water.
The antibacteria in the toll that kills germs is what?
Is chlorosanol.
In the top production, what is the foaming agent there?
The foaming agent is tesafoam.
Okay. And Nate, tell us one safety precaution that we need to observe in the top production.
Do not let your hand touch your mouth during the production.
Okay. What is the meaning of IPA?
The meaning of IPA is isopropyl alcohol.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Now, let me